look at that little Jackson.
Zach is in the World Dwarf Games, and they've been live streaming all of the events.
When are you going to play Dwarf Athletics Association?
I asked Matt to like throw a small little get together in his house. And I'm really thankful that I have in-laws that are so close and so willing to help.
We're going
to
watch your daddy play soccer on the TV, okay?
Unfortunately, Jeremy and Audrey and Karen couldn't make it to our viewing party, but hopefully Amy will have time to stop by.
Aww.
I made a t-shirt for Jackson and I. It said daddy on it and his number. And yeah, just to show him that we're supporting him.
So stinking cute. Oh, look at him just, I'm here, guys. Hi, Max.
Hi.
My new friends Andrea and Liz brought their little boy, Max. And Max has achondroplasia just like Jackson and Zachary.
Oh, he's a soccer player already. Max had a little breakdance thing he did. Very cute. Yeah, you just want to gobble the little guy up. It reinforces that. Just because Jackson's an LP, you know, and he's going to have some tough roads ahead. But Max is happy as can be.
I have two big events happening today. I'm a little bit behind getting ready for Chris's birthday party because I also want to go over and support Tori and Zach, and it's challenging juggling all that. Sometimes you feel like you're in a tug of war. Going over to Matt's house causes me to twinge. Just reminds me of going through the later half of my marriage and then divorce. And that was a dark period of my life. And I don't really desire to be there unless it is regarding one of my kids or something like that. I'm not sure if Karen will be there. It can be hard to see the two of them together, but that's my own issue.
Hey, Amy.
Has the game ended?
No, that's just the hat.
Oh my God, look at all these kiddos, man.
There's lots of food.
Amy doesn't like to come to the DW, but I don't mind going to her house as much as she minds coming into my house. That's her thing. That's not, you know, my thing.
There's Zachary!
Come on, Zach.
Zach's, you know, really involved in the sports part of the little people community, and I think it was really good for Zach to participate in that. That's quite a good support group.
Come on, Zach. Come on, shoot it from right there, babe. Oh!
Pretty sure Jackson's going to be a little soccer player at some point, you know. So I think Zach's being involved still is important for Jackson's future.
No way! Are you kidding me?
Great Britain won.
Oh, poor Zachary. We still love you.
Oh, geez. You guys, I got to go, man. I've got a thing to do.
What are you doing?
Birthday party for Chris. A personal relationship is important, but my family is definitely important, and I think it's worth the effort to try and, you know, make both things work.
Thank you for coming.
Thanks for coming over, Amy.
My poor boy.
Love you.
Amy and I are always going to have our frictions and things.
Bye.
But I thought it was good that she felt comfortable enough to come over and be part of the party. And, you know, that's the way it should be.
Oh, gosh. Did he just throw up on me? Amy, how can I help you?
I'm just going to make the dressing, cut up onions, and then I am good. I'm a little late getting to Chris's birthday party.
Do you have a use for this lemon? Were you planning on using that
for
anything?
No, do you need it? Balancing a personal relationship and your family life is hard. You know, there are going to have to be probably some sacrifices. But I wanted to throw a birthday party for Chris. It's a very important step in our relationship.
Hi.
Glad you're here.
You know, these are Chris's very close friends. I'm the newbie, so of course you want to impress them all.
That's great. Hi.
I definitely hope that everything goes well and I get to throw more birthday parties with him.
Amy, where would you like the parsley?
So the mushrooms are probably just going to go in a bowl then? Or?
Oh, yeah. Darn it. I forgot. I invited Lisa. She's a very good friend of mine, and she likes Chris. And I think being able to combine all of our friends together is also important to me. Do you want it turned over?
Yeah.
So you having a good time?
Yeah. Thank you.
Well, you guys, we're ready to eat, so sit anywhere except these two chairs. You know, I've been around Chris's friends, you know, several times, and I'm hoping that they all welcome me into their group, because if this is gonna work, that we're together, I would like to know your friends. Okay, I wanna hear stories about Chris. You guys gotta tell me some good stories. You all have known him way so long.
Rick is the longest.
I'm under a gag order.
Oh, come on, he better not told you that. Don't pay attention to him.
I could go the horribly embarrassing, he'll never talk to me way again.
Oh, well, maybe.
Why would you want to do that?
I wouldn't. Right. So Chris came over. You know, we had some dinner and just talked. We did get to this relationship. One of the things that I will say that Chris said was...
I'm so scared.
Me too. Chris said, it's just so easy.
Yeah.
It's just such an easy relationship.
It is.
I think I've probably done more this year than the last 3 to 5 years because I had someone to do it with. And so, yeah, a lot of fun.
Kudos to you.
Amy said the same thing. It was like, we have a good time, we can communicate, there's no stress.
Yeah, we really haven't had any drama yet.
No.
I've never been in a relationship like this. I think with Matt and I, as I look back, Matt was like, these are my friends, these are your friends. They always had to be separate. But I definitely think Chris and I are on a better road when it comes to friendships. You know, it's just different.
Cheers to Chris and Amy. Yay.
I can't imagine Chris not being a part of my life. We're understanding each other a little bit more each and every day. I mean, that's what I see. That's what I'm hoping. That's what I think we have. Hopefully, I'm not blindsided.
There you go. Happy birthday.
My wish won't come true.
Yes, it